Okay, students, are you clear or not? So these two points you have to keep in your mind, then only you can make the good decision P. So for the given data set, you can have the possibility to make many decision tree, but you have to select which is a simple and also very useful and covered all the data, that also you have to select. So choose the simple data set for your decision tree. Okay, so these are the points when you are making the decision tree, you have to keep it in your mind. Next, high order thinking. Decision trees are made on the basis of the data set we have and change according to the parameter which we take into consideration for modeling. So which data set or which parameters is affecting your output, that you have to give more importance. Next, many times the data set might have the redundant data. Sometimes the data may be repeated. That is, some data might not hold importance while developing the decision tree. So some, when we are making the decision tree, some data is not useful or not getting the link. For this, one needs to visualize the relation amongst all the parameters given the data and then formulate the model. So what I showed in the first slide, no, that is only here basically. Okay. Next, I had given one assignment. Maybe some students are trying, maybe. How many students are trying that one? So what are the parameters here? The following is a data set comprising of four parameters which lead to the prediction of whether an elephant would be spotted or not. The parameters which affect the prediction are outlook, temperature, humidity and wind. So based on this parameter, so it will be decided whether the elephant will be spotted or not. How many students have tried this one? Aditya Mageswari, temperature, humidity, wind. Ah, okay. You made the decision tree. Magamath, how many students are made this one? Yes, I tried to make. Okay, very good. So whatever the assignment is given, that you have to try. Whether may be correct or wrong, that we will decide next. First you should try, then only you can have some idea, you can understand the concept. If you are not trying, then there is no use. So first you have to find out what are the parameters here. Parameter already said in the last class also, outlook, temperature, humidity and wind. And something may be repeated, that also you can check. So first you have to go through this data fully. So here you check, for example, you take the outlook parameter. In outlook parameter, what are the possibilities there or values there or data is there, that you check. You can see that repeated data also is there. Outlook. In outlook, what are the data is there? Just you mention it, sunny, overcast, rain. That's all. Sunny, overcast and rain. Are you clear or wrong? Same thing, temperature. Hot, mild, cool. Next, humidity. High, normal. High and normal. Wind. What are the data is there? Weak, strong. Weak, strong. Then based on this parameters only, it is giving elephant spotted or not. So you can check overcast, and temperature hot and humidity high and wind weak is yes. Okay. So that way we have to go through the data. Next, we can take which can use as a root, which we can use as a leaf. That I am showing the next slide. There also you can see in your screen. See, this is a decision tree. So you can also note this decision tree in your book, page number 92. Page number 92, one page is given, one empty page is given. There you can note it. So you can use a pencil, scale, then you can use this one. First you can take this outlook. When outlook is sunny, outlook, what are the possibility data is there? Sunny, overcast, rain. Okay? So when the outlook is overcast, so the elephant is spotted, yes. So we can say outlook, overcast, then yes. When outlook, when sunny is there, then humidity also will be depend. You can take one more branch. Humidity. When humidity is high, it will be no. The elephant won't be stopped, won't be spotted out. Then another one is the outlook, sunny. Then humidity is normal, it will be yes. That is only I had given at the bottom of the slide. You can see common decisions are as follows. If outlook equal to sunny and humidity is high, then elephant spotted equal to no. Second, if outlook equal to sunny and humidity equal to normal, then elephant spotted is yes. You can compare with the data set also. Okay, then third point, if outlook equal to overcast, then elephant spotted equal to yes. Then fourth, if outlook equal to rain and wind equal to strong, then the elephant spotted equal to no. Then last one, if outlook equal to rain and wind equal to weak, then elephant spotted equal to yes. This is a decision tree based on the given data set. You can mark this also in your book, page number 92, using pencil. In meantime, I am taking attendance. After that, we can continue for the next one activity. That is. And page number 93, now, there they are asking some questions. So that question, what is your point of view, that you can write. Answer the following questions according to the previous exercises. So with this exercise only they are asking the question. Did you manage to draw the decision tree without any assistance? Whether yes or no, that you have to write. Next, was it challenging for you to draw the decision tree for this data set? If so, why? If you are facing any problem, you can write to make a decision tree and write the reason also. Were all the parameters equally important for the decision tree? Did you notice any redundant data? If yes, what was it? So what are the redundant data that you can write? Then whether all the data are equally important given or not. If anything not given, that you can mention also. Then last fourth, what if the data set had more than 1000 data sets? Will decision tree say be a suitable model for it? Why? Suppose they had given very limited data, okay. Suppose they are giving huge amount of data, whether the decision tree is possible or not. Definitely it is not possible. So there one more approach is there. What are the two approaches? AI modeling, two type of AI modeling now. One is rule based and another one is a learning based. So it is a, the decision tree, it is a rule based. Whenever we are having huge amount of data, we can switch over to there. We can go for the machine learning. Understand or not? So there you have to mention that is the fourth point. Whenever we are having huge amount of data, the rule based approach is not suitable. There we can use a machine learning approach. Okay, ML and DL, that we can use. Okay, learning based approach. Okay, now you give attendance. Same thing, you note this decision tree in your book page number that I mentioned already. Said na, that page number you note it. In meantime, you give attendance. So those are having the mic, you can tell. Those are not having the mic, you can enter in the chat window. But today very less, poor attendance. Okay, A section 104, Gurmeet.
Present, sir.
Okay, 8, Neelam Sisodia.
Present, sir.
10, Siali Singh.
Present, sir.
Okay, 11, Sarastha Patarji.
Present, sir.
Then 13, Tamanna.
Present, sir.
Then 14, Vibhagada.
Present, sir.
15, Artha Sakshara.
Present, sir.
Then 16, Akash Sakshana.
Present, sir.
Okay, 20, Akash Vijay.
Present, sir.
25, Garvit Kumar.
Present, sir.
31, Mohammed.
Present, sir.
Then 37, Rasi. Rasi.
Present.
Okay, B section 201. Aarti Guja.
Present, sir.
202. Jaya Panchal.
Present, sir.
4. Lakshita Gowdam.
Present, sir.
Okay, 6. Mohini Shukla. Mohini Shukla. Mic not working. Okay. Parul. Okay. Then 11, Prableen Kaur. Prableen Kaur. Okay, 14, Supraja. Mohini Shukla, you have given attendance. 17. Okay. 17, Aditya Maheshwari.
Present, sir.
Then 22, Dhruv Prajapati.
Present, sir.
Jaya Panchal, Mohini Shukla, you had given attendance. Don't enter again and again. Then 23, Garvit Sharma.
Present, sir.
Then 24, Hardik Jay.
Present, sir.
Okay, 26, Manish Udaya.
Present, sir.
27, Neil Kosa.
Present, sir.
Okay. Noted it? This decision tree you copied or not? Those are having the system, you can use the screen printing also. Suppose you would not write now and you can give the screen printing. Or suppose you are using a mobile device, there also you can use the screenshot you can take. Yes. Okay. So, now we discussed one example for the rule-based approach. There some online application also is there to draw the decision tree that I had mentioned here. You note it and also you can search and open through the Google also. Online website to draw the decision tree. You can use one of the following online apps. Create key and Smart Draw, Lucid Chart, that also available. You can open and you can try to create the decision tree. After that, you can take the, you can export as a JPG file or PNG file or PNG file. That like you can export as a file also. That is possible. Okay. So three application is there. So you open the Google search engine. There you enter the Create and Smart Draw and Lucid Chart. So using these three application, you can use that one. So today we have to finish this one. Okay, the last minute we are having the time, and I will demonstrate to you how to use this one. This is the application, you note it. Okay, the next is this is a decision tree, no? It is a rule-based approach. It is an example for the rule-based approach. Suppose you are having huge amount of data. There, using the decision tree is very difficult. So we can go for the learning-based approach. There one activity is there. That activity I will tell. That is a pixel leaf activity. Pixel leaf activity. Actually, yes, 28. I will give attendance at last. Okay. So now you pay the attention in the class. I will give 28. Have to join in time. Okay. For example, how the system is comparing the images and processing the image, image processing, or capturing the image and comparing the image in the many AI applications are there, no? That is a computer vision applications. How it is functioning, that we will discuss using this one example, that is the pixel leaf activity. So many already discussed about this many models. So learning based approach model and rule based approach model. This decision tree is one of the rule based approach model. So whenever we are having the limited data, or less amount of data, then we can use the decision tree. But when we are having huge amount of data, it is not suitable. So for that we can use this learning based approach. So many that is a computer vision application is there, no? That application is processing the images. It is using the image. How the image is fed into the computer, how it is storing, how it is comparing, that process only here this we will discuss using this pixel leaf activity. Actually this image, you know, it is stored as a pixel. It is a very small dot in the screen. That is a pixel, P-I-X-E-L, small blocks are the small dot, tiny dot. Tiny dot. Okay. So that is a picture, no, it is make as a many pixels. So it is when you are comparing the image, you know, it is a compared based on this pixels only. So if both image has a similar pixel, then it is considered as equal. If it is not equal, then it is not equal. That like it will be mentioning. The computer is calculating that like only. So that we will discuss using one activity, that is a pixel leaf activity. For that, you can take in your book also, that is a page number 95, no? There one grid is given. Okay, that is a matrix form one, grid is given, that you can use it. Okay, so what to do, I will tell how to do, then you can use that also. Okay, so in the book, page number 95, this grid is given. So this page, what should do, you have to take as a Xerox. You take 5 to 10 copy, you take 5 to 10 copy Xerox, you take it. After that, what should do, I will tell one by one, that you can take. Actually, it is a class is there, physical classroom, we can conduct using the students. But here the physical class is not there, so we are using the visual mode only, na? So it is not connected. So what we have, what you can do, you can take 4 or 5 copies, then you can give to your family members. Family members. So you can take 4 copy, or you can take 10 copy. How many members are available in your phone, that like you can take. Then you can do this, then you can understand how it is performing the computer, how it is comparing or storing the images or That you can see. So first you have to take this and take a palm. So here how many columns are there? It is a matrix. You can see how many columns are there, how many rows are there. You leave it that left side one column is there, number is given, na? That column you can leave it, and right side also you can leave it. So 6x6 square block, that like you can take. Okay, this is your template form, that you take it. So on the left side now you give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then right side also you give from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will be useful for the next stages. So only I am telling this number you give it, this time you give it. Or you take that Xerox, there also you can use. Then second stage what should do? Or you can draw in here any paper also. Suppose you don't want to take the Xerox or you are not having the timing, you can take some paper, white paper, there also you can make this type of grid. But when you are putting the line now, if it is equal mean, then comparison purpose it will be easy for you. Okay, then second step what should do, you have to write one uppercase alphabet. Uppercase alphabet. So what is the alphabet? What are the alphabet? A to Z. Don't take the lower case, you take upper case. You take the upper case. A to Z, any letter. Any letter. Understand? For example, you are taking the A letter mean, you ask your brother or sister and father, mother. Okay, individually they also has to write their own state. Their own state. Okay, write an uppercase alphabet on this matrix. The height of the alphabet should be equal to the height of the matrix. From bottom row to top row, it should be touched. That like they have to write. Understand? Somebody is writing the letter, this is the extension code. This letter they will write. Somebody is going to write the style letter, this time. Somebody is going to write this time. So, whatever they do. So, that style they have to write. Okay? Pixel means that is a small tiny dots. Actually, you take the graph paper, no? You take in mathematics that you are using on graph paper, no? In the graph paper, that x-axis and y-axis is joining, no? That point is called as one of the pixel like here. Same thing here, the monitor screen, no? There number of columns are there and also number of rows are there. So the intersection point of row and column called as a pixel. It is very, very small, tiny dots. For example, 800 into 600 mean 800 column and 600 row is there. So when you are divide that monitor 800 into 600, then it is a joining point in X and Y. That is called the pixel. So that is you can identify. Pixel. Clear? Parsing. Okay? So when you write the letter, no, you have to write from bottom row to top row. That like you have to write. Okay, so your alphabet should be, alphabet height should be equal to the matrix height. In other words, it should start from the bottom line of the matrix till the top line. That is only you can say simple. So you can write any capital letter in any handwriting. Somebody is writing your own handwriting. You write your own handwriting, you ask your parents to write their handwriting. Okay? Then, next, this type. I am showing one model. You can see in your screen also this type. So, bottom line to top line. That like you have to write. Okay? Then, clear or not? That is the second stage. So, you have to write this type. So, first you take that. See, there you write this type alphabet, capital. Next, third step, now color the boxes on which the lines of alphabet have fallen. This type, I am showing you, you see. So wherever you draw the line, no, wherever the line is crossing, that box you have to make the shadow, make the shadow. So using pencil or you can use any colors also you can use. So color the boxes on which the lines of the alphabet has fallen. Clear or not? So first you have to write the letter. In that letter, wherever that line is crossing your written line, there that box you have to mark it, shadow it. That entire box you have to shadow. Entire box you have to shadow. Clear? Then next. After this, cut out horizontal strips. Horizontal line is there, no? That line you have to cut using the scissor. Using the scissor, you have to cut horizontal strips of the matrix such that it goes from 1 to 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, and 6, 7. That line you have to cut. I showed here. Cut out the horizontal square of the matrix such that it goes from 1 to 2. 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, and 5 to 6, and 6 to 7. Clear? This way. Very easy. Next, you paste this type. Now paste all the stripes, whichever you cut from. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7. That you have to continuously you have to paste. I showed here the diagram also, you can see. Okay, now you paste all the one in the single strip. All the strips together to form a single paper string. Make sure that the last block should neither be over the first block of the next line. Now, should there be any gap in between the first and the last block? Okay, so this time you have to paste it. So, using the gum or glue, you can paste it this time. Without a paste also you can compare, but I am showing the next page, you can see. This is the main important. Find, okay, so put the strings under your strings and do the addition of all the colored block to get a series of numbers. Blocks without the color count as 0, while the colored ones count as 1. If a column has 3 colored boxes, the summation turns out to be 3. Here I am showing the diagram. So the first column now, you see, anything is added? Anything is added? First column. First column is the first column. Yes, nothing is added. So you have to put the 0. So here you have to write how many shaded boxes is there. Second column, 1, 2, 3. Second column, 3. Fourth column, sorry, third column, 1, 2, 3, 4, number of shadowed bar. Next column, only 1. Next column, no, 0. Next column, 0. Next column, 1. Next column, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next column, 1, 2, 3. Next last column, nothing is there, so 0. So it is just 3. Understand or not? So now you did this type now, same thing, your brother or sister or your family members, parents, no? They also ask you to this type. If you are getting the same number, both images are equal. If you are getting the different, for example, somebody is writing this type model, somebody is writing this type, no? So you will get the different string. So that is identify your image and their image are different. So this type only, the computers comparing the images and storing the images in the compute storage or in the memory. Understand? Clear or not? So, we discussed one example for the rule based and another one example for the learning based. How a teacher performing that also you can see. So, when you are using the similar letter, similar string you can get. Similar value you will get, numerical value when you are having the same letter but a different style, you will get to the different numerical value. That is identified, that is a different. So this type only the image is processed by the computer, which an application. It may be a application or not a application. It is performing that type only. Okay, clear? So next, that is a last stage of the AI project, that is a evaluation. It is not given in your syllabus, that we can know. Already we discussed one example also, that is a diamond. Protect the diamond. Are you remember or not? Yes, Mr. X. So what do you did there? First you find out the problem scoping, next you collected the data, next you design the model. Okay, you represented, after that design the model, then finally explore the data. Yes, after explore only you are going for the modeling. After model, what you do? Testing, that is only evaluation. So whatever you are doing the project or task, finally we have to test whether it is working as per our expectation or not. How you are testing? For example, this diamond protection problem, no? How you tested? So after you made the surveillance system, you send some known person and also unknown person. Okay, then it is whether it is detecting or not. If it is detecting and also giving 100% result, then only you go on for the implementation. That is same thing here, deployment. Deployment, implementation, same thing. Okay, same thing here also. After complete your AI project, next you go for the testing. When you test, you have to use the raw data, exact correct data and also wrong data. When you are giving the correct data, you have to get the correct result. Same thing, when you are giving the wrong data, you have to get the wrong output. Okay, then only it is correct. Okay, so using the sample data, we have to go for the testing. After testing, then you are satisfied and your expected result is coming and your intelligent output you are getting, then you can go for the deployment. You can go for the live. So the making of a judgment about the amount, number or value of something is assessment. That is called as a evaluation. Okay, then in the evaluation step, what we will do? Project evaluation, project deployment, and the system turning. Okay, that is only the evaluation process. Then last, that is it. Okay. If you are having any doubt related to the AI project, you can ask.
No, sir.
Now, second lesson is over. You need to, AI project cycle is over. So, whatever the assignment is given, that you have to complete. Then only you can be thorough about that one. And same thing, you do this activity. You practice this activity. Then only you can understand how the system is scanning your images and storing the images and comparing the images, that you can understand. Okay, this activity is manually we are doing, that like only the computer is processing. Computer is processing to store the images or recognize the face. This and all this is performing this way only. So now second lesson is over. Any doubt related, you can ask.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, then I will demonstrate you about this tool I said, na? Online app to create the decision tree that I will show you. You can also see. First I will open, then after that I will give the sharing, okay? Hold some minutes and I will take it. Okay. Let's go to the ERL for also. It is for create a model. I will give the sharing where you can see. You can try in your home also. I will put this URL also here in your chat window. There you can try in your home. How many students have tried this teachable machine model, reinforcement, and infinity drum? Are you tried or not? You have to try, then only you can know how it is functioning. Okay, this is a decision tree maker, create key. Okay, so here you can click this start drawing now. So once you click the start drawing now, then you will go to the next page. There you can see many tools are available. So using that you can draw the decision tree. If you want the circle, you can select the circle. If you want select the triangle, you can select the triangle. So whatever need that you can select. And arrow also available. It is taking some times because it is net is slow here. Oh, maybe. So depend upon the network only it is working. Just you see. Okay, so here available are templates also available website na. Here you can create the folder and you can create the use the template, and here it is the shapes are available. Use the image. Suppose you want to add the image, if you want to go for the Google search, that also you can go. If you click this template na, there many templates are available. You can select which you want, or there you can select and you can modify. For example, this, just you click the use, then after that you can modify. So you can try, huh? So this type, if you want to modify, that also you can modify, or you want to add the text mean, that also you can add. Okay, so you can use the template, or you can also draw same thing, that is a word available, no? Blank document and a template, that like you can also without a template also you can do. Yes, one doubt, quality RAM or more RAM, which is better? Muhammad Askan. Yes, school is opening, then you will get the circular. Okay, whenever they are having the possibility, then they will give the information to you. Without you, how they will open the report? Muhammad Askan, what you are asking, sir, one doubt, that quality RAM or more RAM, which is better? Regarding hardware? Yes, actually you want to upgrade your system. Same thing, you can also try other application also. That URL I will give, that you try smart draw, and smart to draw that URL. I will paste it. Smart draw. Okay, it is for smart draw. It is also same thing. It is available online. That is also you can try. And another one is there, Lucid chart. Lucid chart. That also I will give. So you try this three app to create the decision tree. If you see you are feeling easy or comfortable, that you can use it. It is a Lucid. Okay. So you try this online app. Then if you are facing any problem after 30 minutes. Okay. Mohammed Arskan, first you have to check your system, which is supported, which RAM is supporting. Or if already you added some RAM name, that you have to find out the slot is there or not. After that you have to select which type of RAM will be support. Up to 64 GB. No, 64 GB is not supporting your system. Maybe you can check. I think you are telling from your mobile maybe. Okay, so you call any service provider, they will check which RAM will be support your system. According to that they will provide. You can ask them. Okay, any other doubt? Okay, tomorrow onwards neural network, that is the third unit, will be started by the madam. You concentrate there. Okay, sometimes I am going for this number two students, and after that I will meet again there. Okay students, thank you very much.
Thank you sir.
Okay, you try this three app. Okay.